My guest today is Timo from the band Armored Dawn. How are you doing, Timo?
I'm great. I'm a little bit hot because it's Brazil, but you know, it's always hot here, even it's winter. Winter finished and the summer is getting closer. So it's gonna get even worse.
Oh, so you're getting ready for summer in Brazil?
Oh yeah, because here it's completely opposite. So you know, like the craziest thing I discovered after I moved here from Finland is that like Christmas is in the hottest part of the year. So that was crazy. Like people go to the beach.
Yeah, that'd be hard to get used to because we're getting ready to be winter here in the States. So thanks for taking the time to chat with me, man, from the green room. Get ready to enjoy that summer. Armored Dawn has blazed back onto the metal scene with your new single, S.O.S., and the video that accompanies that. How great is it to release new music for the fans?
Oh, it's awesome. I mean, it's been like 2 years without practically being stuck at studio, no right. Touring, no nothing, you know, everything stopped. It was, you know, I'm sure it's the time. It's like 2 years that nobody ever expected to happen. It's like a nightmare. You know, nobody ever thought that this would ever happen, just in the movies.
Right. And it
you know,
crazy.
Life, oh yeah, but life goes on. Bands tour, and you know, we are ready to rock again. Practically the 2 years we spent writing more songs. We have more songs, like at least more two, three albums. So
wow, yeah, at least you can.
I'm sure most of the bands have this because you know, everybody got stuck at home. What they ever do is just sit at home on the couch or write music. So most of the musicians just kept writing more songs.
Right.
So there's a lot of music coming up in the next months and years.
Oh yeah. Yeah. So tell us about the track SOS. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, I think this time we had more time to experiment in the studio because, you know, especially our keyboard player, he got more excited to try to do something a little bit more modern. Mm-hmm. So we had more modern, a little bit more modern guitar sounds, more modern keyboard sounds, and we tried to do something commercial, but still heavy, because right. You know that's what we are all up to, because that's what we love, that's what we're all you know, that's what we grew up listening to, heavy music. But try to update the band a little bit, try to get to sound slightly more modern, and see how that goes. And I think it sounds pretty cool. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, it did sound. I'd like the track. I said the track shows a great evolution in your guys' sound. Obviously, you just talked about that, of the sound of Armored Dawn as a band. How do you work and keep evolving in your music, be it writing or performing, etc.? Like you said that you guys tried some new stuff with the keyboards and try to make it more modern. But how do you evolve from that?
Basically, we keep doing like we always did. You know, everybody brings their own influence, and then we join in the studio and keep trying. You know, the good thing for us, what makes things easier for us, is that we have our own recording studio.
Yeah.
So we have practically unlimited time to keep experimenting what we want, and that's kind of it's a blessing and a curse.
Right.
Because you know unless you make some stuff that you have to be ready at some point. You never finish. You always think of something. Oh, this could be made different. Let's change this and let's try something else. And
right.
So that way you never actually never get anything done.
Right.
So that can be a problem also.
Yeah, it seems like a lot of bands now, especially now after all the pandemic stuff, is they have their own studios and they're producing or they're recording their own music. Not only is it beneficial for
Yes.
finances, it's just more, it's easier to do it at home than it
Oh
is to
yes.
travel somewhere and or just send it out to get mastered or whatever.
Oh
Seems like
yes.
a lot of bands are doing that. It seems beneficial and get more
Exactly.
music out that way.
Yeah. It's
Armored
a
Dawn.
technique.
Go ahead, I'm sorry.
Oh yeah, the technology advanced so much that you can practically, like in the last album, most of the guitars we record at home. So basically, what you need like, we use Kemper amp simulator. We use
Right.
those straight to our computers, and then we just record everything at home, send through internet to the other
Right.
guys to see, and then we mix everything in the studio. And so a lot of stuff we did at home ourselves, and then we just join everything together in the studio. And,
Yep, I've seen a lot of that during the pandemic. A lot of bands did that. They're all separate places, and they did their own separate parts and made videos and did online stuff. And it was kind of nice. Some people didn't like it. I enjoyed it myself because at least I seen some of the bands that I like do some virtual concerts or virtual, stuff,
It's better than keep stuff to do nothing. So it's not
Right, and
like a
going
real life thing,
crazy.
but oh yeah.
Yeah. So Armored Dawn's getting ready to release the new album, Brand New Way. Tell us about that, and when can we expect to see that album drop?
I think most likely somewhere in the beginning of the ne next year. So we're gonna release one or two more songs
Okay.
this year, and see how those go. And somewhere in the beginning of the next year, we are planning to release the whole album and start touring. And we are already booking dates both in USA and Europe, and
Awesome,
to r
cool.
really get really 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 get ready to hit the road again. And because
That'd be cool.
that's basically why we are in the band. So
Right. That's exciting.
really.
Yeah, no one
Oh yeah.
joins no one's gonna be a rock star and sit at home. They want to tour
No. Absolutely.
that's awesome. Good news, good news. You guys have worked with some of the top producers, engineers in the business. How has that experience been and helped your music journey as well?
It's really educational because you meet the guys who really know what they're doing. They have decades of experience. You see how they're doing, and you kind of always try to follow somehow. Somehow, always there's something in, and you start doing yourself the things the kind of a little bit the same way. But
Right.
you always learn something. But it's more of a learning experience because ourselves actually we could do quite good quality in our own studio. We can record everything. We have extremely good equipment. We can do good stuff, but it's always excellent to have somebody outside the band, to produce and see something and to have an outside opinion of the songs. Because
Right.
when you keep seeing the songs, you keep 1 year one year writing the songs and recording it, you have a certain vision of the song, but then comes somebody else to say, "Oh no, this doesn't work. We're gonna do it this way, and this is gonna make all the difference." And
Right. It's always good to have constructive criticism and like you said, a
exactly.
second eye out, someone that may hear something that you didn't hear because you wrote the song and you're playing it.
Exactly.
Somebody listening to it
Exactly.
from, that has never heard it, they might say, "Well, what if you tried
Yeah.
this or try that or you should take that out or put this in, etc." But it's good to have good to have that.
Exactly.
So besides the new album dropping, you're kind of answered this question already. You guys are booking some tour dates for US and over Europe and stuff like that. So, anything else looking
Yes.
into 22, going into 23 besides those two things?
I think we're gonna most likely do some of the songs. We're gonna do some videos also.
Okay.
We of course because I think you really need to have a video. I think it used to be more important than today because people today they don't have patience to see videos. I think lots of guys they go to YouTube they see like first 10 seconds of the video. If they like it, maybe they see the half
Right.
of it or the whole of it or, but you still need to have it. So we really try to do that.
I'm glad bands and stuff still put videos out, honestly. No, it's not the same
Yeah.
as the days of MTV, obviously, but
No, no.
they should just get rid of MTV now and all that
Oh
because
yeah.
it's a waste. But I'd like to see that the bands are doing their own video and doing their own cameras and their own editing and stuff like that. It's kind of cool to see. With technology nowadays, it's easier to do too. So, I mean, it's kind of nice to see the bands do that. So, where can fans or anybody find information about the band, what's going on with them, where to find the music and stuff like that?
Yeah, I think like all the bands, you can go to Spotify, Deezer, whatever you have. This all these fancy websites where you find it. You know, I'm too old to have those things. You know, when I listen to music, I try to find a CD store and go to buy CDs and real albums, and that's how I listen to my music. And,
right.
You know, I'm too old to hear music from the internet. So.
Right,
all this stuff, and you know, I'm glad they are, and it's really, I mean, it's a whole other art, you know. Have a whole picture, you can see the whole cover art, and all beautiful. Right. Now what the kids these days, they see have a small picture on the cellular phone where they don't really see what the hell is happening. They see, oh, there's something yellow in the cover, so right, cool. Right. Let's. You know, I really like the real art of the you know, the vinyl. And
right, yeah. I used to have a lot of vinyls when I was younger, but not anymore. I don't have a record player, so, and I, you know, like you said, technology is so. I have iTunes and all my stuff's on there. You know, you just hit the button and it downloads it, and it shows the cover. I always like to have the cover art so I know who it is. You know, if I'm listening to a certain band and I'm like, oh, I know who that is. You know.
Yeah.
Some cover art's just iconic. You know, you automatically know who it is, like Metallica Black Album, or, you know, just stuff like that. You see that cover, you can automatically know what it is. So do you miss, so now that you said you moved to Brazil, do you miss being in Finland?
Oh yeah. I try to visit there. Like this year, I went there twice already. So
gotcha.
To visit family and visit friends and see some local bands playing there. So
yeah,
I just came there from. I think last month I was like a month there. And
right. So I
tried to travel a lot. So
you said you grew up listening to metal. Who's your favorite metal band?
Metal. And actually, I started quite early. I think I started when I was like five. I started listening to Led Zeppelin and Black Sabbath and Deep Purple. So I started.
Yeah.
Real old school, and
right.
Then I think the heaviest stuff I started listening to was in the beginning was Black Sabbath. Then I, of course, I got heavier when I got older. I started listening to Slayer and all kinds of 80s hard rock band, you know, Poison, Mötley Crüe, Van Halen, all these things. And
I just went to the and I saw that they're going to doing their world tour now. Def Leppard and Mötley Crüe, their stadium tour in the States. Yeah, I got to go take pictures there. That was fun. I like.
Oh yeah,
it was a good show. Very well.
Yeah, I think that they're even coming to Sao Paulo next year sometime. Yep. I think in March.
Sure they are. Yeah, I've seen the ad for it, but I didn't see that it was like small. I couldn't see where they were going. I know it's Europe and Latin America. So. Awesome. Again, this has been From the Green Room, and my guest tonight is Timo from the band Armored Dawn. Timo, thanks so much for stopping by. Make sure to check out Armored Dawn on all the usual social media platforms and streaming platforms, and the links will be in the description of the video below. Timo, look forward to seeing some more stuff from you guys, and hopefully you'll come near me and I can come check out a show when you guys come to the United States, and maybe we can headbang together or something, you know?
Oh, definitely. I hope to see you somewhere on the road, and Hope we're gonna get the band as soon as possible to USA to do some touring and rock hard.
Yeah, be on the lookout for the new album, Brand New Way, coming out probably in early part of 23, right?
Yes.
Awesome. Timo, thanks again. Let's chat soon.
Thanks, man. Thanks for having me, and rock on.
Yeah, no problem.